Welcome to Real Estate 360 with real estate expert Kenn Renner. Kenn, there is a lot to talk about every time we get together.
Absolutely.
There's a lot to talk about, yeah. Especially if you're in Texas, especially if you're in Austin, Texas.
Oh my gosh, what a year it's been for Austin, Texas. How about you, Sandy?
It's interesting because given the situation with COVID-19, with the pandemic, thankfully the vaccine is now out.
Yeah.
But Austin continues to thrive, and we just had announcements of Oracle relocating from California. Wow. Its headquarters here. Yeah. Have you seen the campus over there?
Oh, the in Redwood City. Amazing.
No, I'm talking about the one here.
Yeah.
The one on East Riverside.
Yes, downtown.
It's amazing. So let's talk about that because it's had an effect. I mean, it's a big, big deal.
It really is. And so this is our, by the way, Merry Christmas. It is Christmas Eve. I'm glad you were able to work on Christmas Eve. So, hey, say hi to the kids and the family.
I will.
Ho, ho, ho. But you always want to do a little bit of a year in review, kind of, you know, it's been a wild year. I mean, obviously, 2020 was off the charts in weirdness. So like we were talking about the coming into this building here, there's nobody here. It's like out of the Twilight Zone. You remember the older Rod Serling Twilight Zone?
I know. I keep waiting for him to kind of pop out of a closet and say, welcome to the Twilight Zone.
Welcome to Twilight Zone. Yeah, but you know, it's been, we were talking earlier, it's been like the best of times and been the worst of times, right?
Yeah.
I mean, last year at this time, you knew I was flying to California and had been going there for a couple of years, shaking hands and kissing babies, you know, making friends.
The Pied Piper. And,
yeah, the Pied Piper, because that's where I'm from, you know, that's where I grew up. So I was getting back there because I really felt that there was some quiet desperation going on in the Bay Area, just all the things that were going on and that. And so I want to tell them about a little bit, you know, not only to invest in Austin, but hey, it's a great place to live. That's what I do. I moved here in 1993. So I've been here a long time. And I came here for the same reasons way back then when I was in my 20s, as I'm still helping people now. But, you know, the year in review, best of times, worst of times. Obviously, come in March, it was when the pandemic hit, it was everything got shut down and we're all forced to get in with our families and get to know each other again. You know,
that's a fact.
In 2019, it was so busy. I mean, and I work from home. So even working from home, you just don't have that connection. You know, everybody's going in all their different directions. So, you know, we were working from home, schooling from home and, you know, doing the best we can. But, you know, also we started to learn how we can do everything from home. You know, we had our gym was at our home. Our movie theater was our school, church. I even had my chiropractor come over and give me an adjustment. Yeah. So, you know, that's kind of what happened is people started looking, going, you know, if I'm going to be at home and I can work from home, let's get a bigger home. Right. You know, and that's been happening, whether you're living in Austin or not. I mean, we need more space. And so that started right. I mean, our essential services in March, April, we were busy because we were, you know, helping people with housing that we really needed. They needed more space. Now we have people needing more space that are coming in from all over the world, a lot from California and the Bay Area coming in here. They're not only buying real estate, as you know, I've got over 70 properties, investment properties under contract with our investment group. We have a network of investors that are very very active, but now they're also relocating. So we invite them. And like you said, Sandy, the only thing we request of the Californians is?
Don't put beans in our chili.
Yeah, don't put beans in our chili.
True Texas chili does not have beans in it. You're welcome to come.
I didn't even know what brisket was when I got here, when I moved from, but I like brisket.
How do you not?
Yeah. So anyways, yeah, a lot of challenges. You know, we feel real concerned and sorry. We pray for those businesses that got shut down. Like we're talking about Flicks Brew House movie theater that got, you know, 1,200 employees. Now they don't have jobs. And, you know, so it's just everything's changed, right? And so, but that's also forced us to a different, I mean, we now show homes with video and Zoom. I'm selling houses through Zoom. Who would have thought that? So, So, you know, Apple, I mean, I can't believe how fast they're building that building. I mean, every time I turn around, there's another four floors on that building. You know, I mean, just these high tech companies come into town, they do it fast. I mean, Google's already halfway up on their 33 story tower downtown. Amazon's building a 4 million square foot all under one roof distribution center in Pflugerville, and it's already six stories up. Oracle, of course, that was the big announcement last week with they have 125,000 people working for them, you know, around the world. But I mean, to have the headquarters of Oracle move here, and of course, the big one that put us even more in the public eye, which is Tesla. Right. And Elon Musk himself, the second wealthiest guy in the world with the most valuable car company building their next facility and the only car manufacturer. Was it the only car manufacturer? Only, well, anyways, there's a good chance that Tesla will also move their headquarters here.
Wow.
So what has that done for Austin? I mean, it's caused a complete housing shortage. And so we're scrambling and trying to fulfill that. So not only with our reload people, I mean, once again, it's also, you have to be prepared for this market because I was telling you this story. We had a gentleman that came out with his wife to buy a waterfront home in the multi-million dollar price range between $2 and $6 million. We put an offer in on a $2 million waterfront house. There were six offers. He offered $2.211 million, over $211,000 over the asking price. And he came in second place. Whoa. So, and on the investor side, where we do a lot of new construction, LGI Homes last month in November opened up a new section in Liberty Hill, which is a very popular part of the Northwest Corridor, opened up a whole section, allowed investors to buy in there. They sold 100 homes in less than 30 days.
Jeez. Wow.
So my question is for these builders is that how are you going to be able to build that? I mean, that's just one builder in one neighborhood sold 100 homes. So how are you going to be able to, the supply chain is a problem. Refrigerators are now taking 6 weeks if you want the right kind.
So not much improvement since the last time that we visited on that. Things have not gotten better in that field.
It's gotten better. The big issue last summer was lumber. Mm-hmm. So not only did we have a couple of hurricanes that took down some stuff, we have this boom of people wanting to build more, you know, houses. We're actually very short nationwide on housing. People think, oh, this is a big bubble. I said, no, it's not. We were building in 2001, 2003, about a little over 1.2 million to 1.3 million homes a year. We're at only 900,000 homes a year right now, according to National Association of Realtors. So we're way behind on, we don't have enough housing nationwide. But Austin in particular, we'll get to the stats, is an incredible shortage of supply. What does that do with supply and demand, just demand? I mean, even from fifth grade, our girls could tell us when there's too much demand and not enough supply, prices go up. And so that's what we're banking off. Rents are going up as well. Okay. So, and really the big push is into the suburbs. And once again, I'm looking around these commercial buildings, they're all empty and everybody's working from home. You know, these CEOs of these companies are going to scratch their head. If we can be just as productive with people working from home, why would I pay for this big giant building here? So that's coming down the line.
And the people that own the buildings are scratching their heads too. Well, what are we going to do?
Hey, there's the solving the homeless problem. We just put all the homeless people in the big, tall high rises. There we go. Give them a place to stay. So.
All right. Okay.
All right. Do you need to cut that out?
No, I don't.
I just want to make sure I'm not being politically.
It just didn't work in New York City very well. They put him in the nice high rise in the hotel.
They did that?
In hotels.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, on the Upper West Side, and the neighbors, it didn't go well.
Okay. Well, so, you know, that's kind of what we're looking at is being able to work from anywhere has really driven people to the suburbs. And I'm right in the middle of that. That's where we, and so it's been a kind of a blessing and also an exhaustion. It's been busy. But one thing I want to tell my clients and my people on my podcast is I'm never too busy for a client to help a client out. I get this all the time. It says, there you are writing books, doing magazine articles, podcast videos, you're selling all these houses. And it's because I care. So, but it's also, my wife told me, she says, you know, somebody told me one time, if you want something done, give it to a busy man. Right.
Yeah.
So I get the job done and I'm never too busy. So one of the ways to get a hold of me, made it really cool, streamlined, is callkenn.com. That's call Kenn, KENN.com. And what that is, it's an online scheduler. So you can just pick your time and it'll text us 10 minutes before we're supposed to be online and I'll give you all the time you need. So callkenn.com is my online scheduler. All right. And buyaustin.com, buyaustin.com is my website. And I have a lot of great resources, both for relocation and for investors on that. Okay. So we've talked a little bit about, we'd already been working. I mean, last year at this time we were doing bus rides for investment groups. And I was flying out to California and meeting and greeting people and then getting them interested. And then we started last summer doing virtual bus tours because we could, you know, and that worked out really good. And we actually did it with Google Earth and Google Maps and video and all that kind of stuff. And we'll be picking that back up in January. So definitely get signed up with me for the you know, just email me or get a hold of me at buyaustin.com and get signed up for those virtual bus tours.
A lot Tell me more about those. We've visited before, but maybe someone didn't see it before. You know.
So when we would do a real bus tour, I would have maybe we would have people come out, and usually about a dozen or two, you know, that's why I had to have a bus, so 15, 20 people. We used to do caravans if it was just a few people, but, and we'd have a lot of fun because they would all come out, and then we'd go from subdivision to subdivision, and we would walk through the model homes and the select properties, and that way you get a real feel for the area. We'd have lunch together. We would talk about, you know, we'd all mastermind, and it was really fun because, yeah, it was really, really cool. But, you know, that was a year ago, and that's when you could drive from subdivision to subdivision. And they had things available, right? They had inventory. We don't have any inventory. It's very, very tight, very tight. And so the previous podcast I have, if you're interested in knowing about the housing shortage here, watch that podcast because that talks about the builder shutdown. They actually shut down sales because they couldn't keep up with the demand of how to build these houses.
In your entire career, which is a lengthy one, have you ever seen that before?
Stop building? No.
Stop building?
Well, you know, we're now seeing what I feared came upon me as in some neighborhoods, they're doing lotteries or bidding.
Yeah, I remember you talking about that. Yes,
they're doing lotteries. In other words, we've got three homes to sell this month, and there's 20 people in the hat, and we're going to pull the name out of the hat for the privilege of spending your $500,000 on this.
Right.
House, right. So lotteries are starting to happen. Waiting lists for sure. In some ways, I'm even on a waiting list. I've got a lot of A buyers, and A meaning they're ready to go. They got their checks in hand. So it all goes back down to relationship, and that's something that we built with these on-site agents. And these, I mean, I can pick up the phone and talk to the CEO of Lennar Homes, or they all know me. You know, all the builders know me, and they know that I'm here to do business and help our clients out. But I want to talk a little bit about you know, what's happening here, the package bundle. I encourage you to go back to some of those podcasts that I did where the benefits of real estate. But we're going to talk a little bit about leverage. And what leverage is the one big thing that there's appreciation. The benefits are appreciation. You know, the value goes up. Depreciation, you get some tax benefits. Income, you have rental coming in. In other words, somebody else is paying off the mortgage, which is great. That means they're paying off your debt. And there's also debt reduction as they do that. There's also fixed rate mortgages being at 3% on investment property, low cost of money, and then leverage. And so those are the benefits that you get, a bundle of benefits that you get on real estate that you don't get in other forms of investing. So I want to show you, we're going to talk a little bit about the stats in the Austin area. I just pulled this up as I always do. I usually start off with the stats on our podcast, but an incredible, amazing, from November to 2019 to 2020, we had a 19% increase in values. Okay, so that's amazing. So what you had that was worth $200,000 last year is now worth $240,000. You can do the math yourself. Just call it 20%. Some of the things I want to point out here too is go down the bottom right-hand corner is the 0.9 month supply of houses. That's about as low. I mean, the August was 0.8. That's the lowest I've ever seen it. That is way too low for a city of 2 million people. Okay, we have 2,842 houses in the market for a city of 2 million people. We have 15,000 real estate agents and only 2,800 homes for sale. So we're seeing bidding wars, multiple offer situations. Last night we did one, there was 9 offers on it. It's very frustrating. You know, people think, oh, real estate agents must be doing great out there. I'm like, well, not unless you have those deep relationships with these on-site agents or what have you, because everybody's making offers on these resale properties and only one's getting it. So it's frustrating. You got to be prepared for that. What I really want to point out is the down 55%, active listings down 55%. And there's just no, that's the problem with the supply that we have. So what is it doing is driving prices up 20%. Let me show you the power of leverage. And not that there's very many $200,000 houses out there, but this is, we just did one, a project called Saddle Creek Twin Homes, and our clients did receive $17,000 in instant equity for closing. They put them under contract in February of last year, and their first closings are happening now. So they got to ride that appreciation. But let's take it as $200,000 property, and they put 20% down. That's $40,000, right? If it's the same thing that happened here, that the stats, it went up 20%. If it went up 20%, like the Austin MSA, that means your $40,000, the value of the 20% is on the entire value of the property, right? Mm-hmm. So if it's gone up 20% has gone up 40K. So what is your return on your equity invested? It's 100%. So if you put in 40K and it's gone up 40K, that's 100% return just for buying it. And then even at a 5% appreciation rate, that when you're only putting up 20%, if something goes up 5%, that's a 25% return on your equity invested. That's right. The beauty of real estate. It's leverage. And when things are going up, of course, you know, and when things are going down, it works the opposite. But in Austin, over the last 40 years, we've never seen a drop in median prices. It's wow. It's leveled out. And I've got those charts in my webinar that talks about how, you know, how from the Texas A&M University, the chart that shows the last.
I remember it.
Yeah, yeah. It's on there. So anyways, that's the power of that. That's what we're really seeing right now and what we're seeing some of our clients doing. We were obviously trying to get homes in Austin Metro between 220 and 270. That's kind of our sweet spot. It's almost like we can't find it. We do have a few communities right now that we're working. They're going very quickly. And so when they're sold out and they're done, then we have nothing. We have to wait for the new section to open up. And then you're going to pay more because they're always going to raise the prices. Mm-hmm. Or they're just cutting investors off completely. So some of the strategies some of our current clients are doing is change their geographics, maybe go further, a little further out, go to some of what we call submarkets. There's another point, a way you can change it is change your price point. Instead of in Austin, if you know, go to 300 to 400,000. My house that I just bought my brand new house out in Santa Rita Ranch. And so thank you very much, Sandy.
Congratulations.
but the current house that I have, that is worth 550 and it's gone up 150,000 in the last 2 years. So, I mean, it's only gonna be a break even for me, but I'm gonna keep it, right? If it's going up 1% per month, or in some cases, even more than 1% per month, that $500,000 house is making me $5,000 a month in equity every month without having to work for it.
Wow.
And somebody else is paying off a mortgage. Right. So that's the beauty of real estate along with all the other benefits. So it's not what you can buy in Austin like it was a year ago, it's if you can buy.
Right.
That's why you have to have relationships with people who are in this in the grind all day long. And 90% of real estate is sold by 10% of the guys and gals out there. So change the paradigm is my notes here. And get in now. If you bought last year, okay, so I have a portfolio of over $2 million in real estate. If it's gone up 20%, what did I make last year just in equity growth? $400,000.
Right.
Nice. Okay, so give me a call. Callken.com or 512-423-5626.
And he can do it for you,
too.
I can
help you. Yeah, we showed you what you could get, right? So rather than be sequestered in that little three-bedroom, one-bath house in the Bay Area with your three kids and the two dogs, we're much more open out here. We got a lot bigger houses. That house you can get for $1.4 million in a lakefront community. Or you can turn that one house in the Bay Area into these nine houses. Mm-hmm. So that's what we're helping people do, or they're just diversifying out of the stock market because they're a little scared of it.
Can't blame them for that when you get returns like that.
Yeah. And then when the poster child for stocks has been Tesla, right? What if 1,000% or whatever? And now he's moved here, the richest man, second richest man, and got to be one of the smartest man.
You know, I read something interesting, Ken, that those guys like the Bill Gates and Warren Buffett's and you know, Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos, McKinsey, his ex-wife, their wealth has grown since the beginning of the pandemic. Right. So let's just say mid-March till now, to the point that they could give every American $3,000 and still have more money than when the pandemic started. Wow.
Well, that we could finally solve the problem.
I just
that would be a stimulus.
I don't know what I don't know how the government would find a problem with that, but they would. they would like, hey, where's ours?
Break it up in an antitrust lawsuit.
Something, right? Yeah. It's amazing though.
All right.
Amazing.
Well, we definitely welcome people from all over the world, and that's what we're seeing. Lots of cultures. Austin's always been a mixing and we welcome all. We would love to help you. I moved here 25 years ago from California. And it was I got here as quick as I could. You know, I love California, but weather's great But hey, with some of the things we were talking about, cost of living, housing, the traffic, taxation is a big deal. That's one of the reasons these mega guys are moving out there. I mean, the tax rate's going up, and then it's taxation without representation. Because if you look at the infrastructure, the highways aren't being built the way for all that money that they're collecting. You know, homelessness, which is a problem, but the near homelessness and the fires and the floods, the power outages. We've got plenty of power here, Californians. Come on out. We'll take care of it. So don't blame me. They're coming anyways. I just want to help them get a house.
Plenty of power. Apparently of energy. Yeah, it's here.
Lots of energy. It's here. So, and we got Tesla and Oracle.
Right.
And Apple and Amazon and Google.
Yep, people are going to reach out to you. It's always good catching up with you, Ken. Thank you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. We'll see you next time.